Hey friends, we'll be back into this new video tutorial with OSP Pro. In the previous video, guys, I showed you how to get started with your using Postman and your actually this open source API Johnson data that we already have here, and we really have different versions of it. So it has very many data. So this is the domain, this is the website, has got very many thousands and millions of requests that people tend to request per month. It has got a lot of data. I think you can see this to-do list, you know. So meaning if you just do this and try to push around, they have got several data. This gives you one record. That implies if I move that, you get thousands of record. That implies if I just want to pass for, I'm passing the ID number 4. That implies if you're using it, if you leave without doing any passing any parameters there, you definitely get a lot of record within there. They have a lot of stuff that you can as well request. You have posts, you have comments, you get. So if you try to cross check around on their records, you should find a way how you can at least get some good number of, you know, this support. So this is just a simple demo kind of a response that we tend to get. Actually, the record, the Johnson that we tend to get, that they have on their sample. Now in this video, now I'm going to just walk you direct to create with you guys a sample project that is going to be in position to deal with. Let me just get one simple data. I'm not going to look onto comments, I'm going to look onto posts. So I'm going to just leave one, just post. And remember here, if you just pass one, that implies I'm specifying that given particular ID. If you say 30, means I'm looking to that ID number 30. You get the point? If I leave like that, that implies I'm leaving it on open. So I'll guys will show you how to create this. I said comment down on the comment section if you want me to show you how to create a post, especially post, you know, so not post but API with either PHP, because I know with the PHP gonna be kind of a little bit faster for me, because I've been developing up on the PHP so ground. So make sure you do that. If you're totally interested, comment down below on the comment down below, and then you let me know. Or you can as well join my WhatsApp group. I am always active. I'll respond back to you. Yeah, and if you guys need to do this course with me personally and you want to register for it, I'm going to share with you guys a link as well as where you guys can also register for the course, and I do with you in a simple way around learn Flutter. Now let's just go straight dive into the course, and then we see how best we can actually have all these stuff, if possible, integrated into our applications. So look, I'm just going to first of all create my Flutter application that we're going to be CD Flutter apps. So CD one last tutorials that we already have there. So inside of there, I'm going to just create my simple Flutter create one last. We're looking to HTTP request. If you guys remember that, it's an HTTP post request. So HTTP post. So I'm going to show you at the moment using that post that we already have here. How do you post this very data? So I have an ID there, I have the ID here, I have the title, I have the body. So how do you react to it? How do you respond to it? How does it really work out? So we're going to be looking into how best we can have all those stuffs integrated into our into our Flutter application. Now remember, this is it. So if you go back here into our project, I'm just going to look onto getting on known as a Flutter HTTP request that we already said here. So HTTP request, I think it was called request, if I'm not mistaken. So this called be HTTP post, sorry. Yeah, HTTP post, that's it. Now remember, there are some things that you need to add into your Flutter application for it to work, because if you don't add it, it not actually definitely work out for you. So what comes first, first come first, is this. We need to know how to start using up an HTTP. The best way to start up using an HTTP, if you go to this, if you go to, I want to just show something. If you go to, let me just utilize this part here, I just explain to you something shortly. If you go to pubspec.yaml, now if you look onto HTTP in Flutter, so this is it, how to install it. You get, so this is some of their sample code that they tend to tell you how best this thing can be done using wait and URL. You have to pass that URL. I will show also this all of them if it's okay with you. But now my point at the moment is not that. My point is at the moment how to install and how to have an HTTP into your Flutter application. So how do you do that? How do you have all those things, if possible, integrated? Now remember, you have to install that package into your application. When you click here, this is what you have to do. This is to add for you. of the add for me that into your application. This is a very good method. It adds for all the libraries needed that we need to push into. So if you get back into our application here, I tried to move, I go to pubspec.yaml inside here. This is what we need to add in. It has to be underneath our Flutter here so that we can have those stuffs there. But the best way to do is just use resources to do this, to go inside here and say cd to http post, you know. So this is going to be a post, we're going to be posting HTTP post. Then on the other way around, what we need now to come up with is this. So we need to now to pass this into our Flutter application. Okay, so that gives us a complete chance to see how best we can actually have all those stuffs into our Flutter application. So if you do that, this is what will happen. So our Flutter application is going to look onto all of this to run it into and be added into our Flutter part of the project. So if you check back in here, if everything's done, I think you can see it's adding, and I think it has added it here. I think you can see if you do that, it becomes a good, but you can select the version you want to use if it's fine with you. Yeah, so I think it's not done with adding that. If you just check back here again on our project, we should actually have this added in. I think you can see it's done with adding. This is summarizing, it's adding. So it has added up for us all the packages that we really need to have, which is something very, very important. Now, let me just now, since we already have all those stuff, let's dive into our part of the project that we're going to be creating up a simple application using this. So I'm going to use an ID, title, body, and all those stuff. Now to get this part requested done, so the first thing first comes in. So on top of this, I'm just going to move this off, it's okay with you, so that I just have that like that. So the first thing I'm going to do is to create a stateless widget, which is going to be my app, like so. This is going to be a material app. You guys, if you remember, I always use material app in my app applications. And this is going to be a home page that I'm going to define into on my project. Now the next thing that I can also do at the moment, remember, we need a lot of stuff to pass through. If you check here, we have some few things. I have these parameters. I have the ID, user ID, ID, title, body that I need to pass through. So you can actually come into just this section here, you know. Yeah, passing this, just passing my Flutter. I'm just passing actually the HTTP data that we want to use into our Flutter application. So meaning in simple term, I can actually create a class here, maybe a class for users. If maybe I'm going to use users, because this one's, if you check here, they're actually users. So this is user ID, the title, the ID, which is maybe from a different whatever, the title of their request, and the body of the statement they want to, or something they want to work up with. So meaning to pass through something of that sort, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to just pass in through there and try to pass my users. So I have the first one is an ID, which is going to be user ID, ID, then title. So to do that, I'm just going to pass in whatever I know I have to pass. We have user ID, if you guys check there, which in simple term, user ID is an integer. So to handle this in the professional way, the user ID is an int, you get? But how do I want it to respond? I want it to be the final stage of our Flutter application that we really look onto having. Now to pass through this all, I'm going to just copy that. So we have another one is also an ID here, which also, that's an ID. So this is the final integer, that is going to be a string, that's going to be a string value, and this is going to be a title, you get? Yes. So we also have another one there, which is going to be a string, but it's going to be the body of our Flutter application. That if you check here, we have user ID. You can actually just pick the way it is with the capitalized format if it is fine with you. This user ID, sorry for that, user ID. So this is it. So we have the class users, so I can actually make small letters. So the class users that we have into our Flutter application here is giving us final, that so it must be initialized. So add later, blah blah, construct, blah blah, if you want to use it in this way. So now remember, I'm going to tell you something. I've said here something like this. Now we can actually utilize it like that, or you can actually pass it inside here so that our Flutter application gets to know what you're going to be doing. So I've already initialized there, whereby here I'm like passing up these parameters into. So the best way to handle that if you guys check very well on my previous application, I already have this that we have there. So if you remove this, we get that error. Now what I'm going to pass inside there, I'm going to tell the users that that user we already have is going to be inside the curl bracket. So I'm going to talk of this that we have there dot maybe a user ID. You get the user ID. So that definitely gives us a chance. But this one now, like in simple term, I'm passing up a curl. So I'm passing up in the format of an object. But this is going to be it's going to be required. So we can actually pass required if you want. You can pass required within there, so that your Flutter application can do that. But remember, in here you already defined this, so you can actually ignore that into your Flutter if you want. But let me just cut it short for you. The best way and the simplest way you can always handle this is just you from here that we already have that. So initializing, initialize data. Remember the other one, you have depassed them here, you're trying to create them. To initialize this data in simple term, what you have to do, you have to just create users, which is the users we already have. And then in those users that we already have, I open up here. So here, that's where I'm now going to pass my users. So we have this dot the user ID. We also have another user that now maybe this dot those ID. We have this dot one as the body. We also have this dot maybe the title, if that's what we have, title. You get? So that's it. So we have all these records passed through. Now that's what I was trying to say, that this that you're trying to pass is actually going to be required. You can define it as required. You get, this one can also be defined as required, because we need them as a must. So you can also say they're going to be required in our project. You know, let me just cut this one from here so that I just put it in the right way so that you guys don't get lost up. You know, so we also have this here, which is going to also be actually this is also required. You know, yeah, so this is also required. So required, something of that sort. If you want, you can actually organize your code in one way, root, like so. Yeah, so that your code looks to be more organized if it's fine with you. So you already have that. So when you try pressing, that's what you're going to get. So we have read all this request of ours required for us in our Flutter application. Now the next thing that we need to look onto is to create something called a stateful widget. So I've already have my definition, so I've already defined up this. I already have all those. I've required what parameters I'm going to be taking to have my Flutter application actually, if possible, done in that way. Now I've already defined a home here. So the next thing I'm going to do in my home page is define up what is going to be needed. So I'm going to create a stateful widget and I pass my home a roughly, I think I did some mistake on my Flutter stuff, but that shouldn't be a big problem. So I'm just going to pass in here, we have a stateful widget which is going to be passing for us home. Okay, so I already have that. So I don't know why I made my stuff like that. So okay, in simple terms, that's not a big deal. Let me just try to come back here. So here we already have something called a scaffold that you can actually pass into your Flutter application. So we already have home here. So home can actually be a constant if you want to have their constant in there. Now here, this is a scaffold. The scaffold has got one as the app bar and app bar, like that, which can be actually be app bar of your app in simple term. So you can actually pass the one known as the title of your app, and this can be maybe the text that you want to pass, and this can be maybe Flutter HTTP maybe post data. You get? So here, look onto posting the data to our Flutter application. So here can actually be a given simple post. Now this is really what I'm looking at, because if you check, we already have that we tend to have there. So you already have a stateful widget that we are trying to pass into our Flutter application that we are extending, and in simple term, maybe you want to pass in what known as if you want to pass up the title with inside the scaffold and all those other stuffs that maybe you want to pass into your scaffold application. Now remember, there are other few things that need to talk of or think of adding handling into your Flutter application. If you already cross check, we already said something here, home, and this is our home page that we already passed through. Inside the home page, we can define to the site will have some other few things that maybe to apply and get our data. That's the first thing we need to talk about before even going to the Flutter part of it, where we're going to be talking of the app, but the app data and all those stuffs. Because inside here, the scaffold, we can actually decide to request for a safe area. No, that inside the safe area we have different records we can pass through. Now, before going inside there, if you go back outside here, there are a few things we can define. You get that, because we're extending a stateful widget. So here, if maybe I'm applying, in a simple term, if maybe I'm applying to get the request, you know, to get data, you know, from the other URL. This is the URL you're getting data from. If you're applying to get the data from that URL, there's some few things we need to pass through. Like we need to know, remember, Flutter always tend to get, we use the Flutter feature, and then this feature that we are going to pass through later on is going to give us a chance to pass into in a format of a list, because I want to get a list of those records that we are going to be getting, and they are coming from the user. You get? So remember, we defined users table the other side up that we already have. Actually, on our case, they are called users, so I'm passing their users of those records. That's what I'm trying to have there, or that's what actually we have. If you try to cross check from here up, and that's it. So we're trying to pass it there. We want to know the future of this record that you're trying to pass. This in format of a list of them. So we want now to get, maybe to get in a simple term, to get those users or to get the requests that we tend to have, the requests. Now that request is going to be actually a function that we expect to execute later on or to call later on. So we want to synchronize it to our Flutter application, like so. Now what next are we going to do there? We already have that, so we can replace the URL with the URL that we want to come up with on our Flutter application. Like for instance, a string of this URL that we already have, and this URL is actually from this. That's the URL we already have on our Flutter app, if you guys remember that. You can also provide the final stage response. So we need to go, maybe you have the response. I'm sorry if guys, I'm slow for you guys, but I just want to make sure I explain to everyone and understands, so that all of us can be on the same, you know. There are many changes still which I'm going to make here, so that all of us can pass through and we get to have what we really need into this application. So this is it. So if you pass that, we tend to have that. Now remember, this is the URL that you're trying to pass inside here. Well, it's having some errors for now, but don't worry, I'm going to work on that. I'll show how to handle that. So this is the string that you're passing the URL. This is the final stage of that. Now we can also go further, define the response data, or the data we want to respond to. You get response data that we need to pick from the Flutter application, whereby it can actually be, we're waiting for it also in the other way around, but this data we want to pick, instead of waiting for, we already have it from here. So I'm going to just pass the Johnson record, just so that Johnson can decode it, because we already have it decoded, encoded. So we want to pass Johnson, so that Johnson can decode for us the data that we already have from there, which data is coming from this response, not the body of our Flutter application. So that's what you have to put in mind. So that tends to give us a chance to have our data in the other way around. So this Johnson encode gives us a chance to have the just data encoded up. Now the next thing we need to do now is to put the list of those records that we already have. So we already have our table users, so the from users that we already have that. So what do we want to pass? We want to get the users that we already know. This time is going to be in a format of array. So we want to those users that we already know are going to be picking up the data. So you can as well also create up a simple variable whereby this can be fetching up a single user or fetching up a single data from our variables. So from our record that we already have there. So this can be maybe single data that we really look onto having, or the one we already have, or single user that we believe is actually passing, that we're going to pass. Remember, I showed you something here before that we already have that defined our variables, which is that. So underneath here, we want to pass through some of the things that we believe is going to be part of that This is fetching up the URL. This is passing up the response so that we can get that. This list of that, which is actually array. This is an array. You get? So that's like array. We're going to pass an array. This is got fetching up a single, like fetching up a single user from our table. Who's that user now? Who's fetching up a single user? And this can be in the format of this response data that we already have here. So when you pass a single user, mean something like this, so that can actually be that, so that we pass in inside there. So this is single user that you're going to be passing up into our Flutter application. So this single user is going to be talking to users of this response, no, the users we have in our Flutter application, and those users are going to be talking to the users I'm talking to here. Yeah, I can just call to user so that I don't get confused up, because I have two few things that I'm messing up with here. This can just be users to make life simple, and that user now is going to be equivalent to our users that we already have and we're passing through in our Flutter application. So what are they having? They are having this, passing this. We have one as user ID, which we already have there. Now what's user ID all about? This is going to be the single user you're passing here. It's always going to be having the user ID, which is that, but now here this time around we are passing it in format. Remember, it is an object, if you remember. So the same thing comes in there. So here also you can also pass the same thing, and then we just know that check this little, just try to break this if it's okay with you guys, so that we have something organized. I have something organized like this. This will give me a chance to know what I'm doing. So here I'm just going to pass into that by giving that into our application. I can also get into a title, which we already have here, which is that. So there we can do that, like so. I close that also. I also pass the same thing that I now have here, which is that. So you also have that into that. Now remember, we said somewhere here before, if you guys remember, that the response data that we already have, the response, the variable response equals to Johnson dot decode. We are decoding up the response of the body. So there's a mess around there. Now I'm going to correct that later on. I'll show you that. So this users we already have. Check that. So the same users we have here that we are passing here, you can actually quote users in just small letters if you want, and it's what you're passing through here to be what you're passing there. Or you can just call them user if it will confuse you, because I don't want to confuse you. This is users with capital. This is just, this can be anything, can even be X, and you're passing here X so that that X can respond to the data you want to fetch from the user. You get? So if you try to do that, that's what we really have into our Flutter part of this application. So we already have this variable here, and we already have that stuff. So now what do you want to do? We want to add those records into our Flutter application. So I'm going to just get out of here just like this, so that I can actually add this to the list, you know, add it to the list of users, like where we have the complete record. That's our main point at the moment. That implies we are going to be doing it from the X, which we're trying to say with that I've defined here. Now that's going to be that, and then we are adding up the users we know we have, so which is going to be with the X, which we already have that. So this definitely gives us a chance to add that. So if this confuses you a bit, let me just take it back. I just take it back as well, so that you guys don't get confused. So this is just the users you're trying to pass there, and we're adding those very particular users into our stuff. So take that note. Now what do you want to return? We want to return the users who are actually passing through, that you are passing there in this data inside this function. So I just want to return for me the users that we already have into our Flutter application, that we believe they are our users. So we pass them and then return them. So that's it. Now if you check back in there, that should give you a complete swap. Now inside here, instead of passing up a scaffold, I can first turn up something called safe area. So safe area, that really have. So the safe area still has given us a chance to pass in some few things around. So I'm just going to first remove this one off. Good. So we have our safe area like that. So the what does the safe area have? So you want to pass in one of us to turn maybe the scaffold. They let the scaffold be a shield of this application. So we have the maybe a shield which this time around can be a scaffold. So this shield scaffold, remember scaffold has got different things they have to pass through. We have the up bar in the scaffold which can just pass it there so that we can return this up bar onto our scaffold. Remember the up bar has got the title, so you can as well pass in the text that you want to return inside there on your app bar. This can be a Flutter HTTP request or HTTP data. Yeah, if you shake that. Now here there's a constant that I'm trying to pass there. It's okay with you guys. Now also on the other way around, you can put an icon maybe if you want to download something or if you want something of that sort, but I'm not actually interested on that for now. We have this is that. We have this is the scaffold we're trying to pass through. Now remember in our scaffold, if you guys check on the scaffold, this is it. I'm just going to move that one off. If you try to check here, I'm just going to pass the body where we're going to be having up our container. I can actually pass a container today or this time around. So that inside there we have padding of our fruit application that will give me the future to build up, you know, the fruit application that we're going to have. So inside there we won't have the build and the future itself. So like already have the maybe the future, which this time around the future of this is to get the somewhere use the get somewhere, this is it, get response. So get request. So we're actually passing up to get a request of our fruit application. Let me just organize it this way. I don't know whether guys I'm taking for a lot of time, but if I'm taking for a lot of time, don't be worried because I'm building with you something that will help you out. So building, I mean padding. So we already have the padding, which I'm going to try to check here. This container, I'm going to first move this out. So if I'm passing the padding here, it's going to be lgate dot to all of it, which I want it to be like maybe 15. To be like 15 if possible, let it be padding 15. Here you can actually give a constant if you want. You can actually have a constant there. We can actually now go further and talk about the other stuff that we want to pass inside there in our body, like the shard. And this time around is going to be having the future build that we want to pass into. And the future build we have the body, we have the all those stuff. So what am I going to pass there in the future build? I'm going to first pass the future, and this time around it's going to be get the response request that we already defined on top. And then on the other way around, what else do you want to do? We want the builder of our fruit application to get to do for us something called build the context for each part of the application. So here you can pass in as a snapshot if you want, but remember I'm not going to use this method. I'm just want to, when I pass context, let me just say I'm passing there. Okay, snapshot if it's okay with you. And also in the other way around, I want to if possible to sync snapshot this that we already have on our filter application as a snapshot that you already have inside here. So I'm going to just pass that now, but here it's going to confuse you guys. So what I can just say, I'm going to just call it T content for that you're trying to pass there. Remember, I'm going to be building up. You get? So if I'm building up on passing just a context, I can just rather say I'm build for me in simple term the context like that. So here, build a context that I'm passing in here, the context data, synchronize from that data, and then on the other way around, if possible, let's get it. You get? So here, in simple term, we're trying to pass this data, and we're trying to get that response. That's it. So I don't know whether I've got wrong here, but I hope that should work out, because I'm having this build context that I want to build up, and then if possible, let's just copy that same thing, let's paste it to the good. The context that you want to build, which is actually that, pass from this context, synchronize for me, and then get from the snapshot. So what do you want to do at the moment? That if at all, whatever thing I'm passing there is correct. So if this snapshot that we're trying to pass inside here, get, if this actually is having data in the other way around, and that data is called not null. So what do you want to do? If there's nothing like being null there, what I can actually do at the moment is to see how I can return something. So let me just turn some, maybe a container into a Flutter application, and this container is going to be having a shard, and this shard is, maybe I can actually center this shard so that I can actually just center it like so, so that inside here what we have inside that shard, we can just print a text if it's okay with you guys, or I can actually make it reload, if reload it, you know, like circular, if you can see, maybe circular progress indicator for it, so that it just loads for us up, something like that on our Flutter, a part of application. So here you can actually also pass a constant if you want, or you can actually pass a constant around there so that everything looks fine. The body might complete a normally cause null to be returned, but the return type is potentially none multiple. So if you check here, I can't see this. Okay, fine. Let me just start check that later. Okay. So that should do that. So already have that. So I can also give you an else statement here. Now else, what do you want us to do? Else, we want to return a list of the record that we have built. So else return for us a list. So return a list. You get? So we want to return a list of the record in the list view. You get? So I'm going to turn a list dot the builder that we already have. So we're going to pass the item build that we already know. Now remember, the item build we already have is this, which is called one as XT, and this time around CT actually that we already have on the build. And also we may pass in some few stuffs, because if you say we're building up, I need to know what are we building up. We need to build up that. And then we also need to pass in the index, and this time around our index of this Flutter application that you're trying to pass in there is going to be a list title of this Flutter app. So inside there, still I can break it down. We already have the title of the stuff we are going to build, which is going to be giving us a chance to deal with the text, to have a text that maybe when somebody happened to do there something, we have a text. But that text is coming from a snapshot that we already have there, and we want to connect it with part of our data that we already have. And this data can be from in the index that we already defined on this part of this record that we already have here, to be quoting it to the title of our Flutter application that we already have on top of our Flutter app. So this points to what we defined somewhere around there on a Flutter application. So we have that. Just move this off. Just move that. So we have this down there. So just don't close there. Good. So we have that. So now remember, that gives us the title of our Flutter application. And also here, we're going to get the subtitle. And that also is the same thing. I just want to print up that given particular text. That's now we already have. It's going to be snapshot. That also the data we want to pick from there. So you want it also to pass for your index, so that from the index part of the application that we already have into our Flutter application, to the body, or where we want to actually get the body of our app. So that gives you a complete clue on how, what next. Now here we look onto connecting padding to it. Maybe you're going to give else to all of it, maybe like maybe only to only maybe the bottom, maybe let the bottom if of every part of the application be to 15 point, maybe something, no, it's okay with you. So this definitely gives you a chance to have a complete look and a complete view of this Flutter application. So that definitely gives us a chance. So here you can also define a constant if you want to have one. So that gives you a complete clue on how Flutter application, but remember, everything here looks fine. So this just communicated what we already have inside here, which is fine. We already have here something called add, and that add is actually we need to do something to make that ad over application really work out. Now remember, on top of it, it's not working because you have not done something called conversion. So if you go back on in the Flutter application, we have some few things to take care of. I've already put that include, but you also need to put something called so that our Flutter application can actually do for us, import for us something like import for us, maybe convert that so that can convert for us everything that we have into what we really need to have. If I save this, this should make sure this tends to go if possible. So you can actually just try to come back here, do this, and I say add method. It's okay. So that I think should work out now. That's great. So now if you save this project, if you cross check again now, I know it looks to be something simple, but I want you guys to understand. So you have turned a user, which is good. Now inside here, this is the old method now to some extent, because if you try to get this way and you try to say create local variable for that, yes, you can create a local variable for that. Now remember, this is what you have to know. In the URL that you are passing inside here on your Flutter application, I've already pushed this here. So I'm going to just try to come in here and I say remove unused, ignore that. If you want to ignore it, you can actually ignore it. Now they pass this, there's a problem somewhere here. I'm going to actually first remove this off. Good. So that if I want to pass this inside here, I'm just going to pass this record. So I'm going to just get this string of mine, and then I just pass it inside here like this. Because so that the response data is this little data we have. The response is that, then the URL is that. So if I move this off from there, okay, good. So that's going to be that. So if you check back in on our Flutter application, we have that part of the Flutter app, and you check what we have onto our Flutter application. Okay. So that's it. So if you check here now, you can get that request if you need. But remember, this should be coming up from your Flutter on what we installed inside the pubspec.yaml. If you check that, so this should give you a complete clue. This gets for you the data that you are trying to respond to, and this is getting for you the record, and this is how you pass that. So trust me, if you do that and everything runs successfully, you should have a complete data pulled to you or pushed, if possible, to your Flutter application. You get? So whereby if you go to terminal and everything looks fine, you should have the record there for you. We have Flutter run. So if everything is okay, trust me, you should have that stuff running out for you on your side. Yeah, if there's any problem, then trust me, it will not work out. Yeah. So what I just changed was this. And maybe the problem you get for is from HTTP, where we said HTTP add. That's where you expect to get some kind of a problem sometimes. But if everything is passed on well, trust me, you should get that into your Flutter application. Yeah. So if it is rendering and everything is okay, we should have response like this in your data, or we should have some response that into your Flutter application. If everything is okay, yeah. So guys, thanks for watching this for, I don't know how many minutes I've used, 30 plus, that's too much. I'm sorry for delaying you guys, but if you find it interesting, please don't forget to subscribe. But I'm going to be making four more videos still, which I'll show you guys how to push and load data using different sources, using our own API and things like that. So I think you can see it's trying to load our record, it's trying to fetch those data that we already have. So it's trying to actually fetch this record here that we already have inside here. Get? Yeah, so if you check that, if you check that, it should give you data. So it's loading it, it's loading up the record. Yeah, so this, if everything wasn't well, should work for us as expected. So what I've told you guys, it can take long because it's for the first time loading up, and I have a problem here. So to fix that, I don't want to just move it off because we expect to have that from here. So if you check here, this is where we did the stuff from. Sometimes you may try to add this and your application turn out to work out for you. If you like, well, upgrade HTTP to upgrade to a later version, so you can say pop that upgrade HTTP. Oh, you actually say Flutter pop upgrade to the latest if possible. It's okay with you. Yes, this is resolving up the dependencies so that you can check that. So I think you can see it has done all those stuffs, and I think it has downloaded up all what's needed. I hope it's okay. So, but I still have this here. It's actually what worries me up, you know? Because it may make this application to just load. That's one of the problems you need to know. So thanks for watching this video, but I'm going to get back to you with a rectified problem and I solve that error if possible. Now this should push for us the record, and we should be in position to see all our data if possible. You get? So if I just try to clear this, debug that to false. Yeah, so just try to get back here. Yeah, so that's it. But thank you for watching.